and you have to have a good grinder. And you have to grind the coffee fairly coarse. I've passed around the ground coffee, and you've all seen what a press pot grind looks like. There's also a fair amount of dust. I know some people who actually take that grind, and they'll quickly sieve it with, you know, household little tiny seeds, you know, those kinds you use for cooking or for making cocktails. To separate sort of the pulp from your liquid. Just sieving it through that so that all the fine particles will fall through and all the coarse particles will stay in the sieve, and then you dump the stuff that's in the sieve into your press. The steep time, typically the dose you do is 7 grams per cup, whatever the manufacturer lists as a cup. And Bodum and other companies always include this thing, which gives you, when it's rounded, roughly 7 grams. Coffee, so you can use this without a scale. You don't need a scale. In fact, I would just recommend using a tablespoon measure, which is roughly 7 grams of coffee. The steep time is 3 to 4 minutes. And the steep time is based on... Now, by the way, this changes if your press pot's an insulated one. I usually do 4 minutes for a typical glass press pot and 3 minutes for an insulated one, partially because the insulated one keeps the water hotter, and the hotter the water is, the more it's going to extract. So I don't want excessive bitters to come out. So if I have an insulated press, I'm going to do a little less steep time. So preheating is just as simple as putting a little bit of water into it and dumping it out. Now we're going to add the ground coffee. So we already measured that. And again, add the hot water. And I give it a little stir to sort of, you know, make the saturation nice and complete. And that's it. Now, with this cup, you may notice it's dropped on top. We'll always get that from fresh ground, fresh roasted coffee. You won't see it so much with stale or coffee that you had pre-ground. Yeah. And then just put the press down, leave it like that, and let it sit for 3 or 4 minutes. We've got 3 or 4.
3.
Okay, that's good. And,
I'm trying to get the coffee wet.
Yeah, I'm trying to basically complete the saturation at the start. It's very simple. When you have your kettle, just, you know, kind of pour it all over and really kind of agitate the grind. So it creates, you know, essentially this nice foam, this sort of nice saturation that's going on. The foam you saw on top is called the bloom. And you will get that from all fresh coffee that you brew with almost any brewed method, whether it's drip, whether it's press pot, back pot, whatever. And bloom is essentially the fresh coffee so fresh it's actually releasing a lot of CO2. And the CO2 wraps itself around coffee oils that normally wouldn't be extracted by water. They're not water soluble. But the CO2 attaches to them. It creates this bloom on top. And the bloom is great because the bloom contributes to body and coffee. Any questions so far?
I think a lot of people wonder why 21 grams.
Well, seven grams per cup is a starting point. Like as I said before, if you make a cup of press pot coffee and you're not happy with how it tastes, you think it's too thin, up the dose, make it 8 grams per cup. You know, add 24 grams for a 3 cup, or 28 grams, sorry, 32 grams, 33 grams for a 4 cup. That's pretty much why. So we're coming up to close to the time where we're done with this coffee, and basically all you do is you plunge it down and serve it up. There's going to be a little sediment. It's normal with a press pot. You saw it all in your samples. Again, that's just a matter of the fact of every grinder you use. I mean, this is a $1,500 grinder we're using, and it still produces what we call fines in the grind. The vast majority of the particles are exactly how we want them ground, but there's always going to be a little dust particles, and a lot of that actually comes from the silver skin.
Yeah, but just underneath
the chafe.
Yeah,
it comes from the chafe that's on the ground coffee. So, all right. So now it's a simple matter of the larger the press, the more difficult it is to press down because the coffee is very resistant to being moved through the water. But with a small one, it's pretty easy to just push it straight down. And again, there's still a little bit of foam on top. So don't squeeze it down too much because then it will... You don't want to like pack it at the bottom because when you really squeeze it down, it can release some excessive bitters that are stored up in the remainder of coffee.
Oh, you can burn yourself.
Or you can burn yourself too, because if you press down at one point, it may actually kind of squirt out the scoop. And if there's, you can see on this, there's a little bit, because I filled it so much, there's a little bit of sort of brown coffee on top. It's just a simple matter of pouring it off, and then you're ready to go. So there, that is the simple crisp method.